Want to make something like this? For someone who has no time in Blender, this took me 13 hours, but I'm going to show you how you can do it in under 5 minutes. Before we get started, make sure you have Blender downloaded. Blender's going to be the 3D workspace we're going to be working with today. First, I want you to find the skin that you want to model. For this example, I'm going to use one of my buddy Sudo's new knives. Go ahead and grab the inspect link for that knife, or whatever you're using. Next, we're going to come over to this website, ʙᴇɴᴇʀ, and paste that link in there. I'll leave the link down below so you can get there easier. Scroll down, make sure your item's right. There's going to be the object files and the texture files. Go ahead and download both of those. Next, you're going to want to bring your image over to any AI upscaler and go ahead and upscale it. I do mine to 4x. If you ask me, the difference is pretty apparent. Now here comes the part that might scare you off. We finally open Blender. But I promise you, if you follow all these steps, it'll be easy. Down below, I have a link for this scene. We're just going to want to drag this blend file in and we'll have this. You can choose any scene you want, but this is the one I chose to do for this tutorial. Now we need to import the weapon. Click File and navigate to Import. Then select the Wavefront Legacy version. Now just locate the OBJ file that you downloaded earlier from ʙᴇɴᴇʀ. Once located, it's as simple as clicking Import OBJ. And as you can see here, we have a giant Talon knife in our scene. Just go ahead and click on that and tap your S key to put it in scale mode and move it down with the mouse. You can zoom and move around with your mouse using the scroll and click respectively. Now that we're scaled down to a normal size, we'll use this menu to fine-tune our position. Keep in mind, if you've made any mistakes up to this point, you can just do Control plus Z. This may take some time to get it exactly how you want it, but that's just the art of making it yourself. Once you've got it how you like it, it's time to add your skin to the object. Make sure your object is selected and navigate to the Textures menu. Once you're there, click that little yellow dot next to Base Color and navigate to the Image Texture option. Once you've done that, you should see a little node pop up, and from there you can just open the Image Texture file that we upscaled earlier. Make sure you connect the alphas. Now you'll see that your skin has been applied, but there's still a few steps left to make it look good. First, turn those specular highlights down. I'd recommend giving it some metallic and some clear coat to give it that Source 2 look. Now, let's get that camera right before we render. To switch to the view of your camera, click View, Cameras, and then Active Camera. Then simply select your camera by clicking the dotted lines. You can move this the same way you did earlier with the transform menu, or by simply pressing the G key. To lock in those selections, use your left click. You can also move on the X, Y, and Z axis using the respective keys. Once you've done this, celebrate, because you're literally done. You just have to render it. Once we're done patting our own backs, it's time to render. Simply navigate to the Render tab and click Render Image. Now, this has taken 30 minutes to like an hour for me, but it doesn't take long for a little preview to show for you to make sure everything looks right. But that's it. That's all there is to it. This is my first time making a tutorial video. If you enjoyed and want to see more, please leave a like down below and comment. Just let me know what's up. This has been ʙᴇɴᴇʀ. You guys have a great day. Deuces.